Now let us start the other expressions which can be used to talk about the futurity. After having gone through simple present tense, present progressive tense, and even future, simple future time, now let us go to the other expressions with the help of which we can express the futurity. Now next expression is be going to. Now when can we use be going to? Be going to can be used when you have decided to do something, when your plans are pre-planned, when your actions are planned and you have decided to do something. This form can be used to talk about actions which are already decided by you. For example, your sister is also getting married. If your sister is getting married and you know the date of her wedding ceremony. Okay, so that also can be written here. You can say she is married on 3rd of March. So these actions are already decided. They are planned. Okay, so we can see the form of be going to can be used to talk about the future actions. The actions which are already planned, the actions which you have already decided, the actions which you have already decided to talk about those actions, what you can do? You can use be going to. Okay, subject be is nothing but the form of be, to be form. Okay, and going to, it will be the expression that can be used to talk about the futurity. So, I am going to buy a car tomorrow because I have already decided, we have made up a plan to buy that. So, I am going to buy a car tomorrow. Then, we are going to attend the lecture next week. Soon after the completion of your program, what will you do? Regularly, you will be attending the lecture. So, we are going to attend the lecture next week. She is going to get married on 3rd of March. Okay, being in the present tense, you are speaking of something that will take place. Okay, in the future. So, be going to can also be used for futurity. Okay, apart from present tense, present progressive and simple future, we can see that be going to can also be used to express future. It can be also used to express futurity. Now, this after be going to, let us see which is the other expression that can be used to talk about future. There is an expression called be about to. Okay, be about to is used to talk about immediate actions which are going to happen. Okay, which are going to happen. So, be about to can be used to talk about immediate actions which are going to take place in the future. Immediate future. To talk about immediate future, what do? We use be about to. Example. Okay, let us take example. See the difference. Was to call you, it talks about the past event, but it has to do nothing with the future event. But that could not happen in the past. So, in order to make 1, 2, 3 sentences in the future, what will you do? You have to place what? Auxiliary verbs of present time. So, how will you make this of present time now? Okay. One, I was about to call you. I am about to call you means the action, it is going to happen immediately. So, I am about to happen. So, how will you make it? I am about to happen. About to call you. And then how about this? He is about to finish the work. He is about to finish work. Now, if you say he was, the meaning may go in the past. There is no doubt. But in the past, the meaning is yet to complete. It is yet to complete. Okay. But here, in order to make it in the future, to refer this action to the future, what you have to do? You have to use the tense indicators of the present time. Which are the tense indicators of the present time? The forms of to be, am, is, are. These forms you have to use. And how will you use? He was about to finish the work. He was about to finish the work. And then?
They are about to close this.
Yeah, they are about to close. So, they are, he is. Got a clear idea? So, this can also happen in the past, but in order to make it an example of future, you have to use the forms of to be of present tense. Got a clear idea? Now, I will give you some examples so that you will come to know. The bus is about to leave. That is what we have already discussed. I am about to finish my work. I am about to finish my work. She is about to call you. She is about to call you. When I say she is about to call you, it clearly indicates that action is immediately happen. The action will immediately happen in the future. Action will immediately happen. Okay. Now suppose all of you have planned to go somewhere by bus, and you know that the driver has already arrived. He is on his seat, and one of your friends is outside. So what will you do? You will tell, okay, now don't go anywhere. The bus is about to leave. Amar, what will be your expression? Don't go anywhere. As the driver has arrived, the bus is about to leave. Means the action will take place immediately. Action will take place immediately. At the same time, okay, all of you have already finished your work. All of you have already finished work. Something is left. Okay, almost your work is finished. Only few seconds or a few minutes are left. So then what will you say? Yes, he is about to finish his work. You can say, or I am about to finish my work. I am about to finish my work. So this is how you can use. This is how you can use. Not only to this itself. So, but in the present, what will be there? He is about to finish. With the infinity, it will be only finish. With the past tense, it will be different. Now, they are about to close the shop. Why? Why can you say they are about to close the shop? Because already it is getting darker. Okay. The time is over. Their working hours are over. Their working hours are over. And based on their working hours, what you can say? They are about to close the shop. They are about to close the shop. So, based on this, what you can say? You can use be going to for something which you have already decided to talk of, okay, and then be about to. So when will you use be about to talk about the immediate action in the future? To talk about immediate action in the future, but make sure that you use the forms of to be which belong to the present tense, not the present, not the past tense. Now, which are the forms of to be in the present tense? We know am, is, are. These are the forms of to be that can be used here. We cannot use was and were. We cannot use was and were. Okay, so am will be used with I. Okay, is will be used with singular subject, and are will be used with the plural subject. Now you know which are the singular subjects and plural subjects. Okay, which are the plural subjects? Plural means more than one. Okay, she it singular. Okay. He, she, it singular. You also can be singular if I refer it to one. You, we have you in singular, we have you in plural. Okay. But they, we, people, boys, girls, these are plural subjects. Okay. These are plural subjects. But I will generally go with am. I will generally go with am. I am about to go there. Okay. Suppose if I get a call from my friend, where are you? Dinesh, where are you? So, where are you, Dinesh? If he says, what will be your answer?
I am about to come.
Yes, I am about to reach there. I am about to reach there. In the sense, he will be reaching there immediately. After a short gap. After a short time, he will reach there. So, to talk about immediate future, at the same time, we can use the form of be about to. But don't get confused with the past form. Okay? The past forms of to be. So, this is what you can express your futurity.